greet these people with their family members on arrival in the country. In addition, our organization has helped in settling down these returnees by providing a little training as startup. Furthermore, Synergy Rescue Mission is also involved in community sensitization and awareness raising on the prevention of human trafficking in some states or communities in Nigeria that are notorious for such practices. Some of our success stories include recognition by NAPTIC. I'm happy that how would I call this? Daniel Atokolo. I would like to tell you that the issue of Adetu Latosin, we are still working on it to get a passport for her and the other issues before my table. The NAPTIC Patosu State and the Zona Commander with the Regional Commander can test that we even follow them to arrest some notorious traffickers. Number two, we produce a database comprising of detailed records of name, Nigerian address, telephone contact, traffic country, cities of 2,000 traffic persons, both those that we have assisted to return to Nigeria and those still trapped and looking forward to return to Nigeria. I can tell you up to now, I have 5,000 these sisters working right now in their different countries. Record of dehumanizing and agony of traffic persons when sojourning, my boss has already said because of the little time. Because if I were given an opportunity to mention many victims, I can just cite an example of catering in Iraq. They told the lady that she's going to do a very good job there. Could you believe they did not pay her salary and the other things like that? And she deceased all their educational certificates. If I were to talk on the issue of rape, maltreatment, and others, I have the videos with me because it is what I can say. Let me say something. I'm the first organization by me is the Eminent Activity Foundation. Before I tried to use the opportunity to develop this organization too. Personal relationship with the tongue traffic person until they start a new life. Challenges. This include among others was not restricted to resources but technical financial sources to further facilitate the release, return and division of these surging numbers of ladies, young women. Equitas is needed to fine-tune our operational activities and money should back to validate their return and integration with their families. Intimidation by traffickers who are identified as organizing and facilitating releases of their traffic person and therefore blocking their source of income. Recent harassment of some government agencies who are probably working with merchants of trafficking business. Presently, we have up to 1,250 identified traffic persons who are or have completed negotiation of their release and are eager to return home. Finally, there is need to intensify action on awareness creation in community to prevent new cases in trafficking ladies and young women. So that's it. But to cut it short, I have questions. Because my question goes to the federal government of Nigeria. What is this? We are working to eradicate trafficking, is it not so? And we are still giving the agents, we are still giving them license to recruit. So I do not understand this area. It was a time that government of Ghana, they stopped all their ladies to go to Ghana. Why would we not embark on that system in Nigeria? They come, even at my surprise, we will see the immigration officer at the airport. They know that these are agents trafficking our sisters abroad. And we are still giving these certificates. I do not want to mention the other offices. But you, I can say, the NAPTI, you know the agent. This is the fact. You may not know them, but at least you know two or three agents of these traffickers. Proper action must be done. The government have just concluded their evacuation program. Let me tell you, more than 15 ladies called me yesterday. They evacuated them to Nigeria and they are now planning to go back to Iraq because they evacuated them from Lebanon. Imagine. And this is just like duplicate of effort. We need to provide something for this lady to make them settle, to make their life bearable. But by saying that, that's why I'm telling you, when they insist on evacuation, rescue mission, we do not have money to evacuate. That's it. I'm tackling a very obstacle by fighting with their bosses. That's my major assignment. Yeah. But I'm so sorry, okay? I'm sorry.
Yeah, you have said so much.
Please, let me have this thing, sir. Yeah. Regarding the Philippine government, the Philippine government, they have strategy for their children. Although one of our lecturers have said something regarding to that issue. If anything happened to Philippine children, you will see them coming to rescue their sisters. But right now, whenever we talk to the embassy, I will not mention any embassy. They used to block our number and telephone. They block my numbers. I have all their numbers. What are all these? I think they are representing us. And they know that they are raping these sisters. We have all the evidence with us, but we... Oh, I'm so sorry. This is my contribution to this something. I'm very, thank you, sir, my brother.